Let's go back to federal politics. Now, Treasurer Jim Chalmers believes that inflation can be tamed despite the fact that the May rate went from 3.6% to 4%. The money markets are now tipping another interest rate rise. The Treasurer was doing the rounds this morning, spruiking his modified Stage 3 tax cuts. They come into effect tomorrow morning with the new financial year.
We're providing cost of living relief in a substantial and meaningful way, recognising people are doing it tough, but we're also doing it in the most responsible way that we can.
Now, this is a big problem for the government, Joe. Mm. If you have an interest rate rise, or maybe even two, between now and the next federal election, which will probably be about May next year, the government loses the one thing it could possibly take to the public and say they've done, which is bring inflation under control and deliver you a rate cut. And what happens to them then?
Look, I agree. I think if we get one rate rise, you know, you can probably kiss goodbye to majority government. And if we get two, then it's all on for young and old. I hope against hope. I've got, you know, literally my house riding on it, that what Jim Chalmers is saying is right. A couple of things worth noting, and again, maybe I'm just deluded because I'm just thinking about my own mortgage going up. But one is that the May figure doesn't actually take into account what was in the federal budget, because that wasn't handed down until the end of May. So it may be that, you know, was this speculation about a big spending budget and then it wasn't as big spending as people thought? I don't know. I doubt people, when they're going out and spending, think, oh, I wonder what's coming up in the federal budget. But anyway. So there is that. So presumably, I know there's been a bit of disagreement or whatever you have, or sort of arguing the toss with the RBA and Treasury, but clearly no budget gets put together without a whole bunch of completely apolitical boffins at Treasury whose sole purpose in life is to, you know, to provide good economic policy. They're not bleeding hearts. They're the least bleeding heart bureaucracy in the government.
No, they're all just boring bastards.
They're incredibly boring. But again, all they care about is things like getting inflation to within the target bandwidth. So I just cannot imagine that a whole bunch of them, A, said, oh, let's just give all this money out and it's not going to have any impact, or B, that they said that there's no way you can do this because it will just set fire to inflation again. And Chalmers said, oh, don't worry about that, don't care. So because Chalmers is a sensible man. So I'm hoping against hope that the June numbers will come down, and if they don't, and if we do see another rate rise, it will be just bad news.
It'll be absolute bedlam. And Michelle Bullock, the Reserve Bank Governor, Sam, has already sort of indicated that it's a possibility. They're not ruling anything in or out at this stage. And people are doing it hard enough as it is. They get their Stage 3 tax cut tomorrow and they get $300 off their power bill and poof, it's all gone. Mm.
And that's exactly right. I'm sure she is absolutely prepared to increase interest rates if it's necessary. The problem with increasing interest rates, and there's been a number of articles that have pointed this out recently, you've got such a large portion of baby boomers and retirees that have such huge cash assets.
And they're spending.
Mm-hmm. So you increase interest rates and they get more money.
Yes.
And that money gets bigger and bigger. And the people who already have, you know, huge mortgages and are under crippling debt and are finding every possible way they possibly can to cut back their expenditure, they just get hammered again.
Yep.
So the impact that you're going to get from every increase in interest rates, and that's the only lever that the Reserve Bank have.
Yeah,
they've
correct.
Got one lever yep. and it's interest rates backwards and forwards. That's it.
And I was really critical of the rate rises last year, but I acknowledge that, you know, it's the only lever the RBA has. It has to respond to what's in front of it. But it's such a blunt instrument because it only affects a certain portion, you know, two-thirds of the population, which is people who have a mortgage or people who are living in homes owned by other people who own it via a mortgage, i.e. renters. And if you're like me, who owns a property which is rented out but also lives in a rental property, well, you're doubly stuffed.